This edition of Tech Talk is brought to you by GlobalSpeak.com, new media consultants, corporate video and audio communications, video and audio production and distribution, live and virtual event production. Tag TV and Tag Radio is a service of GlobalSpeak.com, creatively delivering powerful marketing, video, and audio solutions. Tino, welcome to Tech Talk.
Thanks, Frank. It's great to be back on this side of the radio program, so good to be here.
You know, I'm curious. Every time I come to the Tech Square, I see this guy running around in circles around the building, and I understand that you're still conditioning and you're not going to take on drawing a red line in the sand that this year you will be faster than. So I think that, you know, one of the things I want to talk about is faster than Tino, past, present, and future. So let's go into a little bit of that. But obviously, one of the things that we're all excited about, believe it or not, I'm in the eighth year now, October 1st. It's the Techie 10K. Let's go into a little bit about something that I don't think most people, if they haven't been part of it, really get. And that's how much this particular event has become more than something health-conscious technologists want to participate in. It's really a special day of competition and networking. So maybe go into a little bit of that component of it, and we'll get more detail about the actual event.
Well, the fun thing about this event is people have every year there's more and more teams that are participating, and people will bring their company jerseys, and there's even companies that have created cheers for this particular event, and they love the photos, they love the camaraderie. Some of them are walkers, some are runners, some are actually decent runners, everybody working together and having a lot of fun. Networking is always a good piece, as you know, Frank, to all of our programs. But this one, because of the setting and the day and the music and the race, it all comes together, and it's a really good representation of what TAG's all about.
Really, I think, and really is the word, it's a real situation. Networking under normal circumstances obviously has to do with business to a degree. There's something special. There's something in the air at this particular event where everybody kind of breaks down the corporate barrier, if you will, and really just gets down into the fun and the excitement and the competition, to be very candid. It's at Technology Park at Peachtree Corners, and obviously registration October the 1st. Everybody listening is going to want to make sure that is there any preliminary information and any way to sign up in advance?
Yeah. There's, I think we already have over 200 runners signed up. It's on active.com. Anybody that's in the running community knows that. They can also register at the TAG site. There'll be registration at the site that day. But when they register in advance, we know, for example, their shirt size, and we like to lay claim to having some of the nicest shirts that any race has. We spend a little more money on the shirts than most, and so we'll have it all ready for them that morning with their size and their name. So not to mislead anybody, their name won't be on the shirt, but we'll have their name ready for them.
And I understand that if I run and come in last, I get a special T-shirt that I made it through the event and passed the finish line last or something like that. I think I'd be at least the most heavy. You talk about heavyweights that turn out for the event. But let's go into, here's another aspect of it that I think, again, if you've been there, you know it. But if you haven't, you really want to kind of get engaged. And that's the competitive aspect of it. You got corporate cups. You got for both the 5K and the 10K. And then you've got the fastest CEO, and then you have the top three finishers, and that's by age group, which is kind of cool. But then one that I was opening when we first started talking a little bit about, I was teasing about it, and that's faster than Tino. That started out, I think, kind of as a whim, I guess, but now it's almost kind of been a tradition. I mean, you're sort of the, I won't say the gold
standard. Not the rabbit.
that's a better way to put it, and I'll play the tortoise. But let's go into a little bit about that. That's got to have, over the years, have really come both a challenge and an exciting opportunity. A lot of fun for you.
It is fun. It's just a way to, you've known me long enough, a way to stimulate some interest in the program, and so that's why we did it originally, and everybody calls me up, and they're very serious, and they ask me, what's my time going to be? And I'm like, I'm not that fast. So, you know, if you're a good runner, you're probably going to pace me there. But it's become a, we've done it every year. And so it's become a really a staple of the activity for the Techie 10K. And also the 5K, if they run, if I run a 5K, we just double it for the 10K time. If I run a 10K, we have a way to work that out for the 5K runners as well. So, and I'll stand at the finish line once I finish, if I do the 5K and give the awards to the 10K people that, that beat my time. So, it's all in good spirit, good fun. And my staff always ask me, Frank, because we give away a prize to those that, that beat my time, how many of those prizes they have to order. So that puts a lot of pressure on me.
Well, you know, the rumor has it that's the same way you handle your golf score. Is that true? Well, one other point that we need to bring up, obviously, is the Tag Education Collaborative and the fact that a portion of the proceeds goes toward what is becoming greater and greater and greater influence over the whole STEM activity. I'd say locally as far as Atlanta, certainly statewide now, but I'd even say that a lot of the activities that you guys are getting involved into as far as the Education Collaborative are even starting to get some national attention. So maybe go into a little bit about the fact of where some of the proceeds end up going.
Yeah, so we the Tag Education Collaborative, first of all, is really been growing each year, taking on a life of its own, if you will, focused on getting kids excited about math, science, technology, and engineering. As you know, there's a huge shortage in those areas. And we've made a dent, and we're continuing to make a dent by STEM Day and Day of Code. And there also is going to be a program for urban inner city kids or underprivileged. So we keep expanding that. This summer we placed about 160 rising high school seniors in summer internships, paid summer internships. So they'll get some of the proceeds will go to them, and some of the proceeds will go to support the greater good of TAG activity. So they're out there participating as well and helping out. All the staff make it a day. They're out there at 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning, setting up for the race, and you know, they stick it out till the end. So it's great, and for a great cause.
Really, and again, have fun, do good. That's really important when you can have that kind of an opportunity. And truly, again, you guys and ladies, if you haven't been, you got to show. If you're even just getting into running, it's a lot of fun to be able to participate in this particular type of situation. But you're going to be really, really surprised by the friendship and the fellowship that happens at the event. We're obviously getting short of time, but before we close, give us a rundown. It starts at 8 a.m., maybe just a quick overview of what happens over the next couple of hours.
Yeah, so people get there 6:30, 7 o'clock. Staff are waiting for them. They pick up their registration kit. They pick up their T-shirt, their goodie bag, and they set up. The people that have teams, some of them have booths. They'll all gather at the booth and get revved up for the race. The disc jockey will be playing great music, energizing music. There'll be somebody helping with maybe some early fitness before they go out, stretching, et cetera. And then the gun goes off, and it's a nice race around Tech Park. And one of the it's not an easy course. It's got some hills, and so it's a bit challenging, but it's a good course. And then once they finish up, there's drink and food and more merriment. Some people bring their babies, and they while they're running, they're in the stroller running along with them, or within the stroller, but they're along with them. And so it's really become somewhat of a family activity as well, which is great. And we've already got several sponsors. A couple that are important is our platinum sponsor Pegasus Systems, and also our gold sponsor SPI. So those two are leading the charge. But there's still time to sponsor a team and support a good cause at the same time.
Okay, quick rundown again, the site to go to if I want to get more information and to register.
Yeah, go to the tagonline.org site if they want to get information about it. They can register there. Or we already have over 100 people registering on active.com, and they can do that up
early
until
bird. Early bird pricing ends September the 9th, so that
right.
they really do need to act now if they really want to take advantage of the special pricing. And then,
right.
And then again, it's the Technology Park, Peachtree Corners. It all happens October 1st. Remember, are you at liberty to expose the actual time that you are running? Multiplied by 2, divided by 3, and
the way you put it together. Yeah, I'd like to kind of keep that a secret, but for those that really want to know, if I do the 10K, I'll probably shoot for like 53 minutes. If I do the 5K, I'll go a little faster than that. So,
okay, you heard it here. Faster than Tino. Let's find out. And also, we'll keep track of the timing. We report it back what actually ends up being the numbers when he crosses.
Yeah, there
the
you go.
Line.
Don't hold me to that number.
Right,
it depends on how I'm feeling.
Again, Technology Park, Peachtree Corners, October 1st. It's all about the Techie 10K, 8th year. Be there, be square. It's going to be fun again. Everybody that's been there comes back. Anyone that joins us the first time, you're going to make it a tradition. Tino, as always, a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. Always fun to see you in training and on the track actually performing. It's pretty cool. That said, thanks. I know you're running around like crazy. Thank you for taking time out of
A video floating around too, Frank, so people might want to go and just check out my training regimen.
Oh, wait a minute. Is there a way we can find it? What is it, on YouTube?
It is on YouTube, yes.
Okay.
It would just be under my name on YouTube or tag.
I'll check and see if it's trending.
Well, it will be after this this podcast.
Again, Tino, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy schedule to join us for a few minutes, and also really for the time that you put into the Techie 10K and the commitment that you make to actually not just be there but actually to participate in it. Started out as something that was fun and fellowship years ago, 8. Now it's a case where it's a tradition to a lot of people, and it's important aspect of what makes tag. So thanks again for all you do, and thanks for taking a few minutes to join us today.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.